It never ceases to amaze me what ends up being controversial on this show. Just as one example, I'm pretty sure I've used stills like this from the movie Bamboozled to illustrate a point multiple times, and I never heard a peep. On the other hand, someone always has a problem with this little guy I throw out every time I have to talk about the 90s sucking. Firstly, folks, yes, I am aware that the quote and image are from The Wrestler, which is a movie about an oblivious has-been failing to cling to idealized memories of his own 1980s youth and stardom. It's an attempt at irony, or self-criticism, or maybe just defanging the myopia in my own outlook before anyone else has a chance to. Secondly, it occurs to me that most of the time when people want to gotcha me about the 90s not being so bad, it takes the form of, "Aw, come on, Bob, the 90s were great! Animaniacs, Gargoyles, Batman the Animated Series, Power Rangers!" And okay, fine, if we're speaking strictly in terms of nostalgic children's television, well, the 80s still wins. Look, what I'm getting at is, it just stands out that hardly anyone ever says, "The 90s was awesome! Booming economy! Birth of mainstream online culture! Relatively few massive long-term military engagements! Did I mention that booming economy?" So, yeah, what I'm trying to say is, I know the 90s was actually a pretty chill time. I mean, I was there. And I also acknowledge that my, let's call it aggressive ambivalence to the decade, is largely personal. My 80s were rather pleasant, my 90s sucked, my 21st century is getting there. The thing is, the whole meme of the 90s sucking, or rather the 90s as a largely disposable decade, sure as hell didn't originate with me. It's a broadly disseminated go-to popular culture thing. In fact, the 90s being kind of a cultural dead zone might be the most widely said thing about the era. See, popular culture has a way, fairly or not, of encapsulating whole decades in simple shorthand. The 1920s were a party, the 1930s were a really bad hangover, the 40s was war, the 50s was conformity resulting from post-war fatigue leading to paranoia, the 60s was revolution, the 70s was revolutionaries throwing themselves a rager party to celebrate all the progress they made, maybe a little too rager of a party. The 80s was about materialism and brief, superficial re-embrace of 50s-style conformity, etc. But the 90s? What was the big theme of the 90s again? And no, I don't think my inability to sum up the 90s is an issue of being too close to it. Hell, the 80s knew what the 80s were about before they were even over. You ever seen Wall Street? That came out in 1987, but it feels like a movie from now, looking back on how ridiculous the 1980s business world was. That wasn't a movie, that was a warning. But when you look at the generation-defining pop culture of the 90s, a lot of it doesn't have anything to do with its actual present time. I mean, look at a lot of the quintessential 90s movies. The inaugural Tarantino trilogy of Reservoir Dogs, Pulp Fiction, and Jackie Brown were all about a retro 70s, 50s groove in one way or another. Forrest Gump? Nuff said. The first wave Kevin Smith movies were all about young characters who on some level are still pining for the late 70s, early 80s. Hell, despite being about the social transformation brought on by the rise of cyberspace in the 90s, The Matrix tried hard to affect a temporally displaced retro-futuristic timelessness. So, by the way, did that Batman cartoon, at least for the first three seasons. Remember how everyone in Gotham City had black and white TVs? Sure, there were a few quintessentially 90s movies that were about the present decade that stood out, like Slacker or Reality Bites, but have you gone back and watched Reality Bites lately? I mean, watch the movie, not just looking up that Lisa Loeb video on YouTube. Yeah, Reality Bites is unwatchable. What about the music? The 90s was a big decade for music, to be sure, but a lot of pop was similarly calling back to styles and moments of the past. Hell, for a minute there, swing dancing came back. Grunge was definitely a thing, but it seemed to either flame out quick or get absorbed into the established hard rock scene. Honestly, I'd say the most thriving and enduring part of 90s music, and maybe 90s pop culture period, was the mainstream rise of hip-hop, which, yes, emerged first in the 80s, but really came into its own in the 90s. Maybe this might help shed some light on the period. In 1992, political scientist Francis Fukuyama wrote a book called The End of History and the Last Man, which offered up his theory that because the battle between Soviet communism and Western liberal democracy over which form of government would continue to thrive and spread over the globe had been rather decisively won with no plausible new challenger on the horizon, history as we had always known it, i.e. the clash of civilizations and struggle between ideology for dominance, was coming to an end. At the time, many chose to oversimplify Fukuyama's theories as inferring that with nothing major left to fight over, that meant that war itself as a force of history was going to end as well. And about a decade later, we found out how wrong that assumption was. Here's the thing, though. In the 90s, it really was pretty easy, at least here in the United States, to see that as a plausible outlook. The Cold War was just far enough in the past, the War on Terror was just far enough into the future, and the world, just for a moment there, seemed calm and relatively uneventful enough that we could all act like this was somehow up there with the Cuban Missile Crisis. Maybe that's the answer to the riddle of the 90s, or at least part of it. It was the first decade in decades that lacked a lot of the external animating forces that gives a generation its identity within a given culture by encouraging introspection and self-examination. Absent that, the cultural forces of the 90s preoccupied themselves by cherry-picking the past while dreaming of the future, but spending precious little time in the now, or rather, the then. So, did the 90s suck? No, not really. There was a lot of good stuff in the 90s. But there's no escaping, for me anyway, that it was a time that not only didn't have much of a concrete meaning to grab onto in terms of the great sweep of history, but that seemed to actively want that to be the case. And that, well, sucks might not be the best choice of words, but it's definitely unfortunate. I'm Bob, and that's The Big Picture.